Hello everyone. In this video, we will expand waiting line simulation to a problem with two ATM machines. This is an example of building a simulation model for a more complex system. In the previous video, we learned how to build and run a simulation for one ATM machine. So let's say, as a decision maker, we're looking at the outcome statistics and we're not happy with that. What if we add another ATM to the location? Would that improve the situation? Would that decrease the number of customers who have to wait in the line? And also decrease the waiting time? So in this example, we'll expand the model to a two ATM simulations. We are assuming that with another ATM, if all information stays the same, the inter-arrival time still follows the uniform distribution with 0 and 5, and the service times still follow a normal distribution with the mean of 2 and the standard deviations of 0.5 minutes. Let's set up the simulation. The overall setup of this simulation is basically the same. We still have random values, inter-arrival time, arrival time, start time, waiting time, service time, completion time, and time in system. Now we add two columns in this model to reflect the time available for each ATM machine. Basically, this column is telling us when each ATM machine will become available. ATM machine 1 or ATM machine 2. Assuming that ATM machine 1 becomes available first, that means it will be assigned to the first customer in line. And of course, when ATM machine 1 is busy, customer can use ATM machine 2. In this spreadsheet, the random function stays the same. We generate inter-arrival time using the uniform distribution function, same like before with no change. The arrival time for first customer is the same as the inter-arrival time. That means there's no one else waiting in line. As for the start time, the customer can start using ATM machine immediately because there's no one in line, the waiting time is 0. The service time is generated by the normal distribution function, which is 1.9 minutes. The completion time equals start time plus service time, which is 3.9 minutes. So this is the time that he completes all banking transactions. And the time in system equals waiting time plus service time, which is 1.9 minutes, same as the service time. So you assume that the customer comes in and uses ATM machine 1 first, and then the ATM machine 1 becomes available whenever this customer finishes all transactions. This is called the completion time. During that time, ATM machine 2 becomes available immediately because there's no other customer in line. Now look at the second customer. We use the same function for random values. I recalculated it so it will have different values in this trial. For the inter-arrival time, we use the same uniform distribution function to generate the inter-arrival time. For the arrival time for the second customer, it equals the arrival time of the first customer plus the inter-arrival time of the second customer. Now we'll hit F9 to recalculate everything. We can see that the first customer came in and completed all transactions at a time of 4.4 minutes. And that is when the ATM machine 1 will become available again. The second customer comes later at a time of 6.5 minutes. So when he comes, both of those ATM machines are available. We will assume that the second customer will go to whatever ATM machine that becomes available first, in this case, ATM machine 2. This assumption is made to build a model. So the assumption is that a customer comes in, he will go to the machine that becomes available first. Please note that the formula for the start time is a little different than the formula we had before, because now we have two ATM machines. We'll use if function to express the start time. If the arrival time less than the minimum of these times, indicating when ATM machines are available, then it means when he comes, both of these machines are still busy. The ATM machine that becomes available first will be assigned to him, so we have min of J14 and K14. Otherwise, one of the ATM machines available and he can start to use it immediately. That's how we formulate the algorithm. So when this customer comes, if both machines are busy, he will have to wait, and whichever machine becomes available first, he will use it. If he comes and one ATM machine available, he can start using that ATM immediately. In this trial, this customer can start using ATM machine 2 immediately. We calculate the waiting time using the same formula: start time minus arrival time. In this case, the waiting time is 0, and he does not have to wait. The service time follows the normal distribution, so we just copy it over. The completion time uses the same formula, so we drag it down here. The time in system also uses the same formula, so we just copy it down. Let's recalculate to see what happens. The first customer come in and finish all banking transactions at a time of 2.4 minutes. That is why ATM machine 1 will become available at a time of 2.4 minutes for other customers. The ATM machine 2 is available immediately. The second customer comes at a time of 4.16 minutes and he can start using the ATM immediately. In reality, he can choose either ATM machines, but for the purpose of building this model, we assume that he will be assigned to the machine that becomes available first, which is ATM machine 2. And he completes all transactions at a time of 6.4 minutes, and because it requires 2.2 minutes for these transactions. So how can we decide the time available for both ATM machines? In this case, we use another formula. Basically, we say in this trial, ATM machine 1 will be available at a time of 2.42 minutes. And because the second customer will be using the ATM machine 2, this ATM will become available after this customer finishes all transactions, which will be at a time of 6.36 minutes. To have the mathematical expressions, we use if function. If time available of ATM 1 equals to the minimum of these two times available, that means if ATM machine 1 becomes available first, the ATM machine 1 becomes available is the same as the completion time. Thus, ATM machine 1 becomes available after the second customer finishes all transactions. Otherwise, if this customer doesn't use this ATM, its time available is the same as the first trial. We use similar if function for ATM machine 2. If the time available of ATM 2 equals to the minimum of these two, then it is the same as the completion time. Otherwise, it is the same as the time available in the first trial. So we can see that the algorithm and these formulas work. So ATM machine 1 will be used by the first customer and becomes available at the time of 2.4 minutes. Then the second customer comes in and uses this ATM machine 2 because this ATM machine becomes available first at that time. When the second customer is using the ATM machine 2, the ATM machine 1 is still available at the time of 2.4 minutes. In the end of the second trial, the ATM machine 2 will become available after the second customer finishes all transactions, which is a time of 6.36 minutes. Now we double check our formulas to make sure the whole system works correctly. We can copy all these formulas down as we did before. So we can just drag this all the way down to 1000 trials. In the previous video, I checked manual under the calculation option, so I will do it again here. The reason is I do not want Excel does all the calculations spontaneously, which will make the simulation look very confusing. To manually recalculate, we hit F9. And the nice thing is that all operating statistics are recalculated automatically. We can see in here out of 900 customers, only 89 of them have to wait, so the probability of waiting time is almost 10% compared to almost 60% before. The average waiting time is 0.05 minutes, which is very good. The maximum waiting time reduced significantly to 1.77 minutes. And here's an interesting observation. The utilization of ATM machines is still effective. We have total utilization of both machines, which is 81%. And the number of customers that need to wait for more than 1 minute is 12 customers. The probability of waiting times greater than 1 minute is about 1%. Thus, by using two ATM machines, we can see the effectiveness of the system has improved significantly. Of course, we add more ATM machines, the system should work better and the waiting times should reduce. But the question would be whether this is an effective investment. We need to examine whether this machine actually being used or just staying idle most of the time. Idle time means waste of resources. In this example, the utilization of these two ATM machines is 81%. That means it's an effective investment. Two machines have been used effectively and have reduced the waiting time and the waiting life of customers. In conclusion, we can use Monte Carlo simulation in such complex system to support the decision making. Thank you, and bye now.